July 2021, and here at the Mobile Arts Council's gallery at room 1927, we have three different artists featured. We have Malaya Bengel, CJ Foster, and Curtis J. Giarrusso. So since it's World Watercolor Month and Malaya has many watercolors featured in the show, we're going to begin with her exhibition, titled A Creative Coming of Age Show, which is her first ever professional show. So Malaya Bengel is a local painter and illustrator and has been working in the arts for the past 5 years. Her work focuses on mixed mediums, self-expression, and intersectional identities and experiences across marginalized groups. A Creative Coming of Age Show is her first ever solo exhibition and serves as a visual timeline of Bengel's adolescence as shown through her artwork. Some of Bengel's first pieces, which you will see towards the end of this tour of her work, alongside work included in her college portfolio, are displayed here so that viewers are provided with the unique opportunity to see the artist's progression all in one room. This will be the last opportunity to see Bengel's work while she is still local. This fall, Malaya will be moving to New York City to study at the New School, where she will be pursuing a BFA at Parsons School of Design, as well as a BA in the Liberal Arts at Eugene Lang School of the Visual Arts. Malaya says, "Please enjoy the special journey that has been in the years in the making as I prepare to begin the next chapter of my life." For those of you who closely follow our exhibition schedule here at the Arts Council, every 2 years we host the Five Competition, which is a college art competition between Mobile's five area colleges and universities. And Malaya participated the last time we did it at the start of the pandemic, and she won second place overall in that contest. So that's how we were introduced to her and her work, and she approached us with a proposal to exhibit with us in our gallery space, and we are thrilled to finally be exhibiting her work and for her future in the arts. As exhibited in this piece here, Malaya experiments with a variety of mediums, including collage, ink, oil, thread, watercolor, and more. And she specializes in portraiture, which is the bulk of her work, which is on display in our exhibition. This wall features mostly watercolors and ink works from Malaya's Inktober series. For those of you who are familiar with Inktober, it's a fun exercise that a lot of artists who specialize in illustration do through the month of October, where they do spooky themed drawings each day of the month. And as you can see, a lot of these pieces do have a green dot beside them, which anything with a green dot means it has already sold. But if you are interested in making a purchase of any of these works, we of course can ship. Just let us know, give us a call at 251-432-9796, or email us or message us through our social media, and we'll hook you up with one of these original works of art by the very talented Malaya. Most of these illustrations, which are roughly 8 by 10 inches, are priced around $49. For additional pricing, just ask. been calling this one the Showstopper, and she does have prints available of this, as well as some of the other larger works in the exhibition, and some that weren't included in this month's show. As you can see, Malaya has a lot of work on display with us this month. We actually ran out of hangers. Thanks, Malaya. We had to get some command strips. So for her age, she is extremely prolific, very talented. This landscape right here, and the one a couple down, features some of her earlier works. As I mentioned earlier, she's got lots of very affordable prints available. We've got them on display in the back in these bins, which is especially nice for these larger and more colorful pieces such as this one in the very front. And finally, we have a display of her early childhood artwork in the back behind the desk over here. Lots of enlarged eyeballs and sea creatures. Really fun and colorful and unique. And they are also for sale. So wrapping up with Malaya's funky sea creatures, we're now moving into coastal creations and other works featuring a lot of oceanic-inspired ceramics by Curtis J. Giarrusso. So Curtis graduated from the New Orleans Center of Creative Arts and Delgado College for Commercial Art. His studies included sculpture, drawing, design, painting, and art history. He also attended non-credit courses at an early age in drawing, watercolor, acrylics, still life painting, and sculpture. A native of New Orleans, Curtis has been involved in the creative industry his whole life. From creating mud figures as a child to helping his mother with her ceramic shop, Curtis literally grew up with clay in his hands. His first sculpting job started at Barth Brothers, a New Orleans float company, and that was the major sculpting contractor for the 1984 Louisiana World Expo entrance gate. It included two 40-foot mermaids, as you can see on this face, and two large alligator wrestling gods. Another milestone in his career was being approached by Gambino Doll Company to sculpt a Columbus doll for the centennial celebration. Giarrusso was featured in Dolls magazine as a leading sculptor, and his Columbus doll was nominated for Doll of the Year. Curtis quoted, "Working at Gambino Doll Company was a nuptial love of art and beauty. A major influence on Curtis's creative psyche was the painting and sculpting on floats and various embellishments," which, as you can see, Curtis's work is very detailed and very lush. In his career, he's worked with porcelain, paper mache, and clay to produce dramatic concepts and sculpting. Most of the work that Curtis has in his exhibition is for sale, but for those that aren't, Curtis absolutely does take commissions. So if you wanted a custom sink such as this in your home, he could make one just for you. When Curtis isn't working with paper mache or clay, he enjoys working out and practicing yoga, refinishing furniture, restoring his 1852 coastal Creole cottage, and working on creative projects. He's a lover of nature, obviously, and history, and draws inspiration from all of nature. He's constantly looking to live in a better harmony with the natural world, which, I don't know if you would ever see this in nature, but it sure is fun. So this section over here is branched away a little bit from his coastal creations to just showcase some different techniques and styles of Curtis's work. And the staff favorite is this face hugger vase, which almost goes in line with his coastal creations, except, yes, that is a parasitic alien that lays eggs in your face. And finally, we have arrived to Vibrant Take by C.J. Foster. Vibrant Take is a visual audio art company formed by C.J. Foster, known as Uncle C.J. in 2020. C.J. is a 32-year-old MC and producer and digital artist, and these are his digital collages. Between all the mediums, he has more than a decade's worth of experience under his belt. Born in Queens, New York, but raised in Mobile, Alabama, CJ has seen the benefit of a simple Southern upbringing as well as the need to expose home to all different forms of expression. CJ says, "Everything we do down here is art. We just don't have the insight to realize it as such." The idea of Vibrant Take came from the desire to close the gap between hip-hop and fine art. CJ says, "If you really break down the lyrics, hip-hop has produced some of the most amazing literary works of the past century." Originally, Vibrant Take was meant to offer creative services to other musicians, album covers, merch, etc. And while that's still the case, it eventually took on a life of its own. CJ says, "I originally started Vibrant Take as a way to cover the money I was losing in the midst of the pandemic, but I noticed more than just rappers and singers appreciating it. The more I started sharing, the more people were attracted to its artistic value, even separated from the music." CJ is a rarity in that he isn't formally trained in any discipline. The Vibrant Take journey has been equal parts creating, equal parts defining those creations. CJ says, "There's an unapologetic focus on the Black experience in America, but not through a political lens. I replace that with more of a spiritual dialogue, as spirituality is the cornerstone of Blackness, no matter what the context is filtered through. The use of water and skies in the works represent a portal between the inner and outer self, between the imagery we see on a day-to-day, and how it's processed mentally, emotionally, and spiritually." That concludes our July 2021 exhibition tour. Come by and see us at the Mobile Arts Council's gallery at room 1927 on Tuesdays through Fridays from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. or during extended gallery hours on Saturday, July 31st between 1 and 4 p.m. Thanks to everybody who came out and saw us during Art Walk despite the dreary weather. We all know we've gotten our fair share of rain this month. It's always dry in the gallery. Stop by, buy a piece of artwork, appreciate the talent that we have here in Mobile, Alabama. Thanks.